people of the internet, my name is Johnny. Welcome back to yet another FNAF news video. Hope your day's going good, the weekend's almost here. And in today's video, we got a whole bunch of amazing news to talk about, ranging from brand new merchandise to security breach actually coming to the Switch. Who could have seen that coming? As well as a whole bunch of movie news, including some brand new pictures of the entity known as Cawthon. So if you're excited for all this brand new FNAF news, don't forget to scroll down there, give the sub button a little tickle so you don't miss out on any more future FNAF news. And without further ado, boo! Balloon Foxy jump scare. Did that get ya? This is the brand new flocked Balloon Foxy pop and tee bundle from Funko. This was leaked all the way back when the Balloon Circus characters were first getting revealed. It's a bundle that includes this t-shirt of Balloon Foxy on it, as well as a flocked variant of the pop version of Balloon Foxy. I think both items look absolutely adorable. I absolutely will be picking this up. Currently, I believe the only way to get your hands on this is to pre-order it on Amazon UK for a May 14th release. And speaking of merchandise, we've got BioWorld releasing a couple brand new products recently. First up is a Security Breach 5-piece backpack set. As you can see, it comes with all the essentials, the main backpack, a pencil case, as well as a little keychain with the Security Breach logo on it, a lunchbox as well. Honestly, I feel like everything you need possibly for school is available in the set. You've also got this strange 3D youth cosplay zip-up hoodie of Freddy Fazbear. It looks pretty goofy, especially how gigantic the FNAF logo is on the front. Lastly, BioWorld also released some brand new socks themed around Security Breach. Moving on to what is my most anticipated brand new FNAF book coming up, the FNAF cookbook, because a while back we got the full table of contents revealed for the cookbook, and as you can see, there is a whole bunch of recipes. I believe based off the description, there's about over 40, but for categories, you've got Freddy Fazbear's Pizza, Roxanne Wolf's Burgers and Subs, Chica's Chicken, maybe a little cannibalistic, but certainly an interesting category, Chica. Gregory's Pulled Pork, Freddy's Five Nights Classics, Bonnie's Breakfast, Monty Gator's Sweet Things, and Dancing Rabbit Drinks. And speaking of drinks, we got a brand new recipe revealed to us, the Monty Gator's Green with Envy. Now, I don't know about you, I'm always a little hesitant with the recipes when they don't have what the item is in its title, but based off the picture, it looks to be some sort of smoothie or a shake. And interestingly enough, there was a little note on the bottom of one of the pages from Gregory saying, "Look out for Monty Gator. Monty Mystery Mix is a strange green pizza topping glue, which I used to lure and finally destroy Chica, mean and green," from Gregory. So who knows, maybe after all, the cookbook will have a little bit of lore inside of it. That's pretty interesting, a note from Gregory. Next up, we got some news that I honestly didn't think I'd ever say, but Security Breach is coming to the Nintendo Switch. Yesterday, it was revealed from Game Explain that a work in progress build of the Switch port was playable in the halls of the 2023 Game Developers Conference. What you're seeing now is captured footage of the game running on that work in progress build on the Switch. There's no release date for the port just yet, but according to Game Explain, the reflections and graphics look absolutely fantastic, though the game is still a bit choppy in some areas. I'm hoping that since this is still a work in progress build, Steerwool is going to take the time to work through those choppiness and hopefully make the game as smooth as they possibly can on the Switch. So to me at least, the longer it takes for Steerwool to acknowledge the existence of this port, the better. So hopefully, like I said, they're taking the time to sort through some of these big issues, the choppiness, but hearing that the reflections and the textures look great on the Switch is very surprising to hear. Maybe I shouldn't be too shocked because the Help Wanted Switch port also looked very, very graphically good. I'm a little worried about the choppiness and how a massive game like this, and let's also be honest here, also not the most optimized game. I'm just a little worried about how it's gonna run on the Switch. But any and all updates on this port, I'll be sure to let you know. Moving on now to the final topic of today's FNAF news video, the FNAF movie. First up, we've got this picture, which at first you may not recognize what this lot is, but it was where the facade of Freddy Fazbear's Pizza Place was built for the film. But now, since it's been taken down, it appears filming on the facade has concluded. Which makes sense. I know a lot of people were like, oh my god, what, that happened so fast? I mean, keep in mind, it was only the front of the building. I don't imagine they're gonna take that long to film those shots. But I am a little sad that they took it down. It completely makes sense, I'm sure. If they just left it up, it would be vandalized and, you know, dangerous stuff like that. But it's an amazing part of the FNAF movie history. and to see it go is a little heartbreaking. And they better hope they don't need to do any reshoots on that set because, well, I mean, they took it down. Next up, we got some very exciting news. Two-time Emmy Award winning composer Michael Whalen has joined the crew of the film. Whalen's gonna be acting as the main composer for the score of the film, which is very exciting. He's worked on a whole bunch of stuff. Corgo, Veronica Decides to Die. Two films with absolutely phenomenal scores I've heard. He's also worked on the theme songs for, get this, Good Morning America and The Oprah Show. What the heck? Absolutely fantastic news. It's amazing to have someone as talented as Whalen, like I said, two-time Emmy Award-winning composer working on this little FNAF film. Next up for movie news, we've got Kat Connor Sterling, who has officially revealed she's been cast as Max in the movie. We all kind of knew this for a long time because it got leaked out, but she did officially reveal it exclusively with Deadline a couple days ago. And over on Twitter, she decided to fancy us by posting a picture of her when she first got the script for the movie. Obviously not showing anything she shouldn't be, just the front of the script, which as you can see, it's a pretty beefy long script. But on the front it says Five Nights at Freddy's, officially confirming that is the name for the film. A lot of people were thinking maybe it was gonna have a tagline, maybe it was gonna be called FNAF the movie, or who knows, some people still thought it was gonna be called Bad Cupcake. But nope, it's just FNAF. The screenplay was written solely by Scott, which is absolutely insane to think about. My man Scott wrote this whole gosh dang script. Of course, it did have revisions from Emma, who is the director, as well as Seth, as well as showing off the dates for the white, blue, and pink versions of the scripts. Which, if you don't know what that is, don't worry, it's nothing too important. It's just kind of what stage of revitalizing the script it's in. And lastly, some of the most exciting news of all, a few YouTubers you may know, Docco, 8-Bit Ryan, Baz, Razbowski, were flown out to New Orleans by Scott himself to visit the set of the film, shoot some vlogs, take some pictures, watch some behind the scenes for the film, and they've been posting a lot about their trip. As you can see, for the first time in years, some brand new pictures of Scott hanging out with the boys. Fun fact, this is actually Docco's first time actually meeting Scott in person, which just absolutely huge congratulations, Lewis, if you're watching this. They also met up with Emma Tammy, who, like I said previously, is the director for the film, and then also teasing us a little bit as they're reacting to, presumably, one of the sets for the film. Docco tweeting out, the FNAF movie set is beyond incredible and something that I'll never forget. The whole cast, crew, the Jim Henson Company, and Scott have put so much love and passion into this movie, it's truly amazing. So some very exciting news. Once again, huge congratulations to all the boys out there who got to visit the set. Baz also tweeted out, it's worth mentioning, I will be able to talk about my experience on the FNAF set when I am back. I won't be able to show any of the set just yet, but would you like to see me share with you what I've seen in a video? So stay on the lookout for Baz's social media as well as all the other boys' social media to see what they're getting up to on their trip on the FNAF movie set. And if there's any more updates, I'll be sure to let you know. But that is gonna do it for this FNAF news video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all on the flip side. Goodbye.